Welcome class. Today we are revising the lesson The Ailing Planet written by Nani Palkhiwala. Now first of all about the author. This author Nani Palkhiwala was born in 1920 in Bombay, which is now Mumbai. And it was then the Bombay Presidency, and he was born to the blue collar job family. It was a middle class Parsi family, and the profession of this family was of palanquin makers. They were palanquin makers. The author's forefathers were in this job, and it was common practice among Parsis those days to get into these kinds of jobs. He was educated at Master's Tutorial High School and later at St. Xavier's College. Both are in Bombay itself. He was a dedicated scholar and not letting a stammer hold him back. He had this habit of stammering. He had this problem. Then also he excelled. At college, he earned a master's degree in English language and literature and thus overcame his speech problem. Now comes the lesson. So as the title itself says that ailing planet. So ailing, if we talk about ailing, ailing means somebody who is sick. Ailing means sick. And if we are talking about our planet, so obviously we'll be talking about our planet Earth. So here throughout this lesson, we will be talking about our sick planet, that is Earth. So when it comes to the points mentioned here, as you can see, the first point says Earth's health deteriorating each day. Day by day, Earth's health quality is declining. It is becoming worse. Now, in the next point, the reason of this is given. The reason is overexploitation of natural resources for decades. For decades, we have been utilizing, we have been exploiting the natural resources which are present. But what is happening now? The situation has become critical. One thing is very important to notice here that this lesson is an article. It was published in form of an article, and it was published in the year 1995. So we can guess that if in those days the condition was critical, then what about today? Now, exactly the full name of this lesson is, the full title is The Ailing Planet, Green Movement's Role. The writer here will be emphasizing the role of green movement in improving the condition of our planet. The writer says, in 1972, the green movement started, and it helped environmentalists to raise awareness about harmful condition of Earth, that what and how this condition is getting into problem these by days by day. The environmentalists were able to make people aware about this. This movement was successful in educating people about the conservation of environment. So far, during the time of 1995, it was declared that this movement has become successful. Earth is like a patient whose health is declining day by day. This is one of the questions. This line will be given and you will be asked to explain it. It is very easy. You can explain it on the basis of your general awareness. The writer says that Earth now has become a patient and whose health is declining day by day. Because why is it declining? Because we are not providing any kind of treatment to our planet Earth. Now, next point says that in year 1987, the term sustainable development was used first of all by the World Commission on Environment and Development. So what is sustainable development here? Sustainable development here means that utilizing the natural resources but keeping it safe to some extent for future generation as well. Suppose if we are exploiting the forest land, then we have to plant trees for the future generation as well. This way, if we are utilizing the natural resources, this will be called sustainable development. Now, next point here says that there is a zoo in Lusaka, Zambia, where if you go to a cage, there is a cage in which there is a sign which reads, the world's most dangerous animal. And if you look inside the cage, then what you will find that there is a mirror and you will be watching your own reflection. And it is actually true that human beings, we are the most dangerous species existing on earth these days, because it is we are harming the nature, who are over exploiting the nature, and we are harming, and we are not doing anything to preserve natural resources as well. Next point here is, Brand Commission raised a question. This commission, which was established, it raised a question: are we to leave our successors a scorched planet of advancing desert, improvised landscapes, and alien environment? Successors here means upcoming generation. This commission was very concerned that if we are utilizing the natural resources to such an extent, then what are we going to give our upcoming generation? A scorched planet, a burnt planet full of desert and sick landscape, ailing environment. What are we going to give? Now, next point talks about the four principal biological systems which occur in nature and which are the foundation of global economic system. These are fisheries, grassland, forest, and croplands. These are the four principal biological systems, and this also will be one of the answers to questions asked, that what are the four principal biological systems, and you will have to explain all these four. You'll have to write about them in a few words. First of all comes fisheries. Reason is obvious why we are exploiting it, in order to increase our protein intake. Demand is increasing day by day, and for this, to fulfill this need, we are exploiting fisheries and grassland also, and forest also. Forest we are exploiting for fuel and to make our houses. Same we are doing with grassland, and croplands also we are doing same, because the population is increasing, we all need homes, and we are going towards the forest. With these systems becoming unsustainable, fisheries will collapse. Fisheries will collapse. Why? Because we are exploiting it to a level of unsustainable limit. Forest will gradually disappear, grassland will turn into a barren wasteland, and cropland will become worse. These are the effects of over-exploitation of these four principal biological systems. This we are doing. One more thing here is that in poor countries, forests are being cut down for fuel, wood, for cooking. And one more point is added here, that in a few areas, the cost of fuel wood is more than the cost of food which is being cooked. Getting? The cost of fuel is more than the cost of food. The writer also says that rapid growing population is not a good sign. One of the biggest reason of this problem which Earth is facing is rapid growth in population. And this is also the reason of Earth's ill health. The article emphasizes that there is an urgent need to control overpopulation in world. Why? Because according to this article, and according to the writer Nani Palkhivala himself, he says that wherever human beings, wherever mankind is proceeding, deserts are following. Means, first of all, suppose there are forests, humans are reaching there, then we are cutting down the trees and we are turning it into desert. We are finishing the forest. And when we are leaving to other place and we are cutting more and more trees, then what we are leaving behind us, we are leaving only forest. Next point here says that development is the best contraceptive, as it will help in reduction in fertility, increase in education and income, and improvement in health. According to this article, development is one of the best contraceptives. How? Because according to this article and according to the research, it is found that increase in income reduces fertility. Okay, the families which are having more number of kids are not that much affluent, according to this article. And the article also says that increase in education will obviously increase income, and that will improve the health of people. The world must be seen as a whole and not as dissociated parts. We have to think of now world as a family, Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam, not in parts. It is a holistic and ecological view. Now people have started thinking holistically means we are the part of earth, and they have started realizing, according to the Green Movement, which was started in 1972 in New Zealand, one of the points was which were given there was that earth is a living organism. It has its own biological and metabolical needs, and we are ought to fulfill the demands of earth. Now, Lester Brown, according to Lester Brown, we have not inherited the earth from our forefathers, but we have borrowed it from our children, from our future generation here, and we have to return it. Obviously, if you are borrowing anything to use for your personal use, when you are returning it, you have to get the things repaired. If you have damaged it, if you have got some damages while using it, then before returning the thing, you have to repair it. So we have to give this planet to our future generations. So for this, we have to keep on repairing this thing as well. Now comes the theme of the lesson. Obviously, there is only one theme throughout this lesson, this article, that is saving planet Earth. And writer has given a lot of measures also to save. First method is here that we have to keep in mind the sustainable development. We have to make sure that we are not. Second point is that we have to make sure that we are not over-utilizing the four principal biological systems. And third thing is that we have to keep a curb on population. This way also we can help planet Earth, because more population, more needs we have to fulfill, and for the fulfilling these things, people will be needing to over-exploit the natural resources. One of other reasons of over-exploiting natural resources is the greed of human beings. Okay, this greed, because if we are needing five, anything in number five, but we are exploiting it in number 10, because we want to keep the rest of the five in our store in order to keep it for future use, not for future generation, but for future use in order to attain more and more income from this. That was all for this lesson. Thank you everyone for watching.